resilient, bouncing back, keeping the focus. They have to put that first set in their rear view mirror.
Her body time and time again, diving all across the court with those digs.
It's a lot of fun to watch Rosada on Minnesota and Formico on UCLA. Two great liberos.
Formico, the cousin of Kerry Ross Jennings. In the middle, Frager putting it away. Point Bruins. Formico from Saratoga, California. She's the team captain, really the leader many different ways for the Bruins. Again, the cousin of Kerry Ross Jennings, one of the greatest volleyball players of all time. And there's Hart again.
Minnesota. Hart took a look there. And that's, you know, that's what we call in volleyball the garbage set. When the pass isn't on point, you kind of get everything thrown out to the outside. And Hart making it look easy. Two blockers in her face, and she just crushes an angle in front of the defense.
Yeah, you think Seliger Swenson likes setting on this team?
Wow, Riley Buescher using the entire court.
Buescher running back smiling. I don't know. know if she meant to cut it that close or not, but she certainly gets credit for it. And we're tied at six, but you see a lot more smiles than frowns on that UCLA side of the court.
To go for it, but I've seen Will Hyde hit that before.
She has.
She just didn't have a lot of angle to work with because that set was about 8 feet in from the antenna.
And Will Hyde going down the line. We're tied at seven.
Yeah, Sam, you mentioned the body language, the smiles on UCLA. That's a tribute to their coach, Mike Seeley, who is a very even-keeled player as well as coach. And that's what, you know, he teaches out there, to leave the last play behind, have fun out there, and do what you practice.
Nice block, Minnesota. As that is number four in white, Paige Tapp. Averages over a block per set. Minnesota dominating the blocks. Six lead changes in this set already.
Transition. Selger Swenson.
She had 15 digs last night. Extended the lead to four. You know, the only other place I've seen that happen, Dan, is Nebraska. I mean, age does not matter. You see people of all ages sprinting for seats, general admission seats, in Lincoln, just like you do here.
Oh my, this is becoming a blocking exhibition right now by Minnesota. They are on it. They know where the hitters are. They're pressing over. It's eight blocks to one right now, and that has been the difference since midway through the first set.
Would you have expected that in this matchup? Was that a shocking stat to you?
Well, we knew it would happen. I didn't think it could happen. I didn't know if it would happen, and I did not think that there would be this big of a difference. Who knows? I mean, the Bruins, they could go on a blocking tear, but right now it's as if Minnesota is just methodical in their positioning. They seem to be very locked in to where those hitters are going to be, and they're putting up a very technically sound block.
Minnesota's won seven straight points. Senator Swinton trying to win another joust. Tap goes up for the blockers, cannot get it. The block is tooled, it's point UCLA.
Just a little bit too late on closing to the net. And that just goes to show you, if you're a half second too late blocking, it's not going to happen. You are going to get tooled. It's a very technical skill, very hard to perfect.
Wilhoff just had too much time to unload that.
Yeah, she just ripped that straight down the line. I give a lot of credit, Kylie Miller. Took it. She did not flinch.
She had two kills in the first set, four this set. Will Hyde is getting going, the Big Ten Player of the Year. That's not good news for UCLA. Yeah. Jackson. Sides out for the Bruins.
Back in the match, number 10, then Jimmy Frager.
You know, Sam, you mentioned the body language and UCLA having a good time.
Yeah.
Minnesota, very similar. They didn't push a panic button. Remember, at set number one, they were getting beat 6-0. They knew and they have that confidence, and they earned that confidence throughout the year. The Big Ten's such a strong conference, and those last two wins against Nebraska and Wisconsin really took them over the top. They think they can take down anybody at any time, no matter what the score.
Especially on this court, where after every swing, you get this reaction. Will Height has caught fire here in the set. She's up to 7 kills now.
Just all over the court right here. Look at that beautiful dig by Seliger Swenson. Tap with the set that time.
Minnesota only with 1 hitting error so far as well. And there's the creativity, the high volleyball IQ, if you will, of Alexis Hart. Minnesota trying to run away with a set. It is packed. Will Height ready to serve. Minnesota up 16-9 here in the set. And a hammer straight down by Van Winden. She was hot early and cooled off a little bit.
Van Winden coming from the right side here, crushing it right off that left hand. Smart play. Scary thing about Hart, only a freshman, and you see how powerful she is, but she gets up and elevates so high that she doesn't have to hit the ball with a lot of topspin. So she hits kind of this flat tracer, and it's almost impossible to dig.
I love her vertical game. She seems to just float in the air and then brings down the hammer.
Minnesota really running away with this, up 18-10 and dominating the blocks 8-1. You know, that the one block was Riley Buschler, remember, in the first couple of points. And since then, UCLA has yet to block a ball.
There's Riley Buschler getting the kill for UCLA. And Minnesota with only 1 hitting error in this set and 7 for UCLA. UCLA benefits from it.
It all started with a really effective serve by Jordan Anderson, dropping in that four spot, that four service position. And another tough serve gets Minnesota out of sync.
That's Kyra Rogers. She's coming to the lineup for the first time, number 2 in gray. And again, Hart and Will Height have been the go-to for the Golden Gophers.
Hart has all sorts of sharp shots in her arsenal. That time going soft cross court. I think the most impressive shot was that roll shot down the line. It looked like almost a beach volleyball shot. Rarely does a shot with that kind of pace go down.
You know something about that. I'm working with Dane Glenn, Olympic gold medalist in beach volleyball. Do you ever look out during these matches, Dane, and think, wow, she'd be a good beach player?
Yeah, all the time. And it's the players that have a really well-rounded game, because the way the beach works is with only 2 players out there, you have to have all the skills. You can't hide. You can't just be a big blocker or just a defender. You have to have it all. And so many of these athletes, their game translates to that.
There's Buschler again. UCLA has needed a kill. They've gone to Buschler. Buschler is now the first player in the match into double figures. She's got 10 kills.
The crowd sensing a little momentum swing right now, trying to get the Golden Gophers up and running.
UCLA's won 4 of the last 5.
Position, and Seliger Swenson, look how acrobatic she is. running one way, setting the other in the perfect position. That's why she's the Big Ten Setter of the Year.
20th assist. UCLA. You like that idea?
Oh, I love the idea. It was just, she just didn't execute on it. And that's what happens. You want to have the idea. Sure, you're going to miss every once in a while, but showing that you know that open corner is there shows your volleyball IQ.
Going cross court, gets a touch, and gets the point. Seven kills this set for Will Height.
Not sure the call
right
there.
A net violation there.
Net, yes.
On Rogers.
Net violation on number two, Rogers. Just touched the front of the shirt. Any part of your body. I've even seen the ponytail and hair hit the net, and they will call it net.
The moves are calling it. Van Winden with the kill. Minnesota dangerously close to winning the second set and going into intermission. Two sets to none. Formico back to serve. Diving for that. Smart shot by Jordan Anderson.
Little mini rally here for UCLA, trying to cut into this lead, make something happen.
And Will Height joining Buschler and Anderson with 10 kills in the match. And Minnesota with 2 points from a two-set lead.
Somehow manufacture and shoot a few points while serving. Have to take a few risks, but right now the Minnesota Golden Gophers are really on top of their game. Doesn't look like anyone's going to stop them this set.
Minnesota looking for set point after this rally, served by Chandler.
Being called, and the one thing I think it's been somewhat consistent, and that's all that you can really ask for.
It's a 4-point Golden Gopher lead, 23-19. Now it's a 3-point lead.
Timeout, Minnesota.
And Minnesota taking a timeout. A good comeback by the scrappy Bruins. They have won 5 of the last 6 points to get right back in this second set. And if you're Hugh McCutcheon right now, what are you telling your Golden Gophers? How are we going to finish this thing?
Well, right now you're just saying, settle down. All right, we've worked to get to this point. We're just 2 points away. Let's receive serve right here out of this timeout. Let's go to our strength. I wouldn't be surprised if it is Seliger Swenson setting Will Height, who has the hot hand. But they need to get this 24th point right here. If UCLA can score 21 and make it 21-23, that's when things will really tighten up for the Golden Gophers. But the number one priority, and you can see Hugh McCutcheon giving a bit of a talking to his team, they got to take care of business. Let's close this set out right now.
Well, they need to take care of Jordan Anderson and Ryan Buschler as well, as Riley Buschler and Anderson now both in double figures for UCLA.
Buschler with 10 kills, and she started out on fire. A lot of things going her way, tipping off off the block, showing the power, showing the finesse, and she was a steadying force, as well as Jordan Anderson, the senior 6 foot outside hitter for UCLA, playing with a lot of confidence as well. The offense has been there for the Bruins. The big challenge has been defensively. They haven't been able to manufacture the blocks that Minnesota has, and that has been the difference.
Whistler and Anderson with 21 total kills, the rest of the team with just 10. UCLA trying to close the gap to avoid going down two sets into intermission.
Chances to possibly score that point. Now they have to settle down and side out this one.
The Golden Gophers of Minnesota one set away from booking a spot in Columbus, Ohio, in the national semifinals. It is intermission here in Minneapolis.